gonna extend the net in.
Say goodbye to whatever his name is.
Okay. It felt really good, but I was also scared to like fall in and like crush them or something. I was so nervous.
You guys feel like proud parents today?
Yeah.
For months, these students have been raising and observing these endangered Atlantic salmon in their classroom.
It's fun to check on them every day.
And now they got to release the salmon that they raised back into the wild.
Like sad because we've seen them grow up from little eggs into now fry.
Well, now that these salmon are in the stream, they will live here for 1 to 2 years. When they're about 15 centimeters long, they'll make their way down to Lake Ontario.
More than 30 schools are taking part in this project, part of the Toronto Zoo's AquaLinks program. It's all in effort to save the Atlantic salmon population in Ontario.
Due to development of urbanization, habitat destruction, as well as the introduction of dams, we've actually decimated the population naturally.
And now they may have one other concern. Water levels around the province are very high this spring. Conservationists think this could cause some problems for these young fish.
Right now, with high water levels, it's providing more habitat for these young fry to live in. However, it's also creating strong currents in the water.
That may mean that they'll have to use up their energy fighting the current instead of eating. That strong current could cause another problem as well.
Rains and the pollution, you get a lot of silting of the water or dirtying of the water. That could affect them being able to breathe properly. It could actually silt over or cover different areas that are important for habitat.
So these students are hoping for the best for their young fish.
I think they'll do fine because they have each other.
And for the next few weeks, thousands of salmon will be released through programs like this right across Ontario. In Whitby, Audra Brown, City News.